the farmers of Sierra Leone, and this is true for almost all African countries, if not all, you know, they don't have access to funds. They don't have access to money. So even if governments make available inputs, external inputs such as fertilizers, such as seeds to them, governments may give for 1 acre of land. You have 3 acres of land. You have fertilizer for 1 acre. You apply in 3 acres. Straight away, your yields get down. You know, some of these farmers are aware that they are not given the right dose of fertilizer. For example, I'm using that one input as an example, but it cut across and other inputs, I mean. And so I realized that the farmers actually, during the planting season, requires money to go the extra length. If you want to get labor to do your weeding, you have money to hire labor, you know. And if you want to get 3 more bags of fertilizer, you should have money to be able to do these small, small things. So it's not like we are coming to dish out funds to farmers, money to farmers, like that, individual farmers. We don't go for individual farmers. We go for group of farmers, cooperatives. They've come together, they've created their cooperative, they've created their group, and the group must apply for that fund. They must indicate what they want to do with the money, what activities they want to undertake, and they must account for the funds that are given to them. What I tell you, it has worked wonders. I believe it worked wonders because it serves as an incentive, which is taking the youth back to farming. You wouldn't believe the number of youths that have gone back to farming. I said within 1 year of this program, we are able to employ, send back to farming 18,000 youths, different groups, you know, that have gone back to farming. And apart from that, it is creating some kind of competition because we go to verify your field. Before we give you, we prove that you are actually doing something meaningful and you want to work in agriculture. So everybody wants to be the best so that they will get, you know. So it's a program that we started like that, but it has gained momentum so much so that we've seen youth group, straight away, they cultivated 2,000, and I always use this as an example, by the way. They cultivated in 2017. After getting this thing last year, they cultivated small piece of land. This year, they've cultivated 2,050 hectares of land by just that group. Beautiful crop. They've got the money to apply fertilizer across the board on top of what we gave to them. And so their crop is doing very well. And I believe when I saw their field, I said this is going to be 4 or 5 tons crop, where people normally get 1 ton or less than 1 ton per hectare. I will tell you, because of this drive, particularly by the youth and particularly by female farmers to get into farming, 2016, when we started the program, we saw an increase of our yield from 0.87 metric tons per hectare, 0.87, not up to 1 ton. We went straight away to 1.8 tons per hectare. And that was fantastic for the country. We straight away reduced the deficit to self-sufficiency to 40,000 metric tons, which I believe in 2017 we're going to surpass that number and might begin to export our staple food, rice. I'm talking of rice. By the way, well, let's look at the returns. 1% increase in agricultural produce gives return of 2 to 4 times more than any sector of the economy. This is reported by the World Bank several years back. So I believe that agriculture is the start. And if we increase agricultural activities, increase our food production, you might be able to generate funds that you can transfer into other sectors of the economy to increase the economy further. So yes, it is the starting point. And it's a sector that we should continue to support if we want to keep the economy strong. Because the majority of our people are in agriculture, across board in sub-Saharan Africa, you know. And we have the land, we have the water, we have the people. we have the sunshine, we have everything that it takes for us to produce. And that is why I say that agriculture is going to be the breadbasket of the world. I will tell the two-year-old child that, yes, I'm currently the Minister of Agriculture, Forestry and Food Security for my country, Sierra Leone. And I will tell the two-year-old that I believe that one day he also will become a minister or even the president of his country. But he has to work hard for that. It's a two-year-old child, so I will laugh. I will laugh that out with that two-year-old child. But if I see that two-year-old child 15 years later, I'll ask, how far have you gone in preparing yourself to become a president of your country? You know, and then just joke it out with them. But that leaves a mark in the mind of that person. It's like myself. Secondary school from two, there was riot in another country. I said, I will not let that come to my country. Look at where it landed me eventually. I developed something that people that have been trying to do for 50 years, I developed it just like that. The Almighty gave me that initiative to be able to develop it. And I saw myself climbing up and up to take me to where I am today. And I might go higher than that, you know, in the next few weeks or in the next few months. You know, so basically what I'm saying is, leave that true picture, good picture, in the minds of the youths, in the minds of the young people, for them to become somebody tomorrow. I always work with the youth. I always want to take them to higher heights.